lying in the streets, hungry, their bodies devouring themselves.
Another week or so, I'd probably eat you.
I was simply a farmer then. It hadn't rained in the state for months. The ground was so dry that the water had turned to mud, and the mud had turned to dirt. Then the winds picked up and blew so hard there was barely any ground left to stand on, and none for a plant to root. I thought I could stand up to the gods and halt the mighty winds they blew at me from their mouths and butts. I built a wall. I watched and waited and hoped that my plants would grow. And they did grow. But then it finally started to rain. Forever. Well, maybe not forever, but my wall wasn't built for that. When it rains, it pours. I thought there was nothing I could do. I was hopeless. But then I had an idea. My father had been a farmer, but my uncle had been a scientist. And I thought it must be in the blood. I didn't know how right I was. I began experimenting. I tried combining false dragon head with gooseneck loosestrife to help the plant stand against the wind, and I captured the essence of lily pad and fused it with the resilience of cattail to hold fast against the water. Everything seemed to be working at first, but then the sprout began to become frail and withered. I hadn't slept in days at this point, and my mind had been running for weeks. I bent down to examine the plant, and the change in altitude caused my nose to begin to bleed, the first drops landing upon the plant. I rushed to the bathroom to clean myself up. My mind was mad.
She's great.
Mom, I knew it was weird. I knew if they caught me, they would think I was a madman. A madman. The shovel hit the ground, hit the dirt, hit the rock. I dug up that body that was laid to rot 10 minutes earlier. She looked so peaceful. A river of golden hair running down her face, and hair done all up in makeup, with entire true colors. I hacked off her limb. I knew she wouldn't eat it. The night was silent as I slinked back to my laboratory. I approached my plant with a pit in my stomach. I felt like I had a hunger inside me that was unquenchable. I lifted the arm I had exhumed from the grave and held it above my plant and watched as a river of blood poured down upon its leaves. I sat patiently, watching, waiting, but nothing. Had I failed? The plant began to recede, and I stared as the weight of my work pressed down upon my lids, bringing me to a slow and unaware collapse.
Aww.
Bring him back to life.
That's the beginning of the other one.
Keep you up to date on the situation, but it's safe to say The bigger they are, the better they taste. This is Jay, son, Daniels, signing off.